rhyme. Pop music is really great for studying rhyme schemes. Let's look at the Backstreet Boys, for example. Fire and Desire rhyme, so they get Group A. Now we have a new set of rhymes with Say and Way, so we're going to give them Group B. Because we finish one set of rhymes before moving on to the next one, this rhyme scheme is known as rhymed couplets. Now, rhymed couplets are really, really common in pop music, but there's another style of rhyme scheme that's also pretty common in pop music, so let's look at the Spice Girls now. I know, they're your favorite. Here, Smile and Mile, lines 1 and 3, rhyme with each other, so they're Group A. Lines 2 and 4 also rhyme, Me and Me. Now, that's Group B. We call that an identity rhyme when you rhyme a word with itself. This rhyme scheme is called through-written. Now, I'm sure you're probably wondering by this point, how does this apply to songwriting? Well, let's look at Every Breath You Take by The Police. After a long series of A lines, they end on a physically shorter X line that doesn't rhyme with anything in the song and really stands out. Now, this is a well-documented songwriting technique to make the listener feel a little bit uncomfortable or off-kilter. A lot of people think this is a love song. It's actually not. It's actually a stalker song. And they end the phrase on a 6 minor chord to make sure you know that. Okay, so you made it through the boring stuff. Now, here's the fun stuff. These are rap lyrics released by rap group Run-DMC in 1986. Now, you'll notice that we're always talking about the words at the end of the line that rhyme, and this is called end rhyme. And this is basically how very early rap worked, way up until the mid-90s. So let's skip ahead. Here's another Run-DMC song from 1993. Now you'll see that the end rhymes are in fact still in place. But before we were using perfect rhymes at the end of the lines, and now we're using family rhymes, raps and hats. It's close, but it's not perfect. But now they're starting to add another element to their rhyming. In addition to the end rhyme, they're repeating vowel sounds from within the line itself. Jeans and Adidas both have a long E. Same with tough and rough. Now, believe it or not, this rhyming inside the line is called internal rhyme. So this internal rhyme technique is really what's pushing rap in a new direction nowadays. You may have heard people say that it doesn't take talent to write rap music, and I'm going to go ahead and blow that out of the water right now. We're going to look at one of the most efficient uses of internal rhyme in rap history, the first verse of Lose Yourself by Eminem. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes rabbit, he choke, he's so mad. Do is every time I hear a word that has the same vowel sound as another word, I'm going to put them in a column. We're going to make what we call rhyme columns. So the first line of the song is, his palms are sweaty, knees weak. We now have three vowel sounds to work with right off the bat. Knees and weak both share the long E sound, so they're going to share a column. Palms and arms are a near rhyme, as are sweaty and heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already, mom's spaghetti. He's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready. And then from here, it's just rapid fire to drop bombs, but he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's joking now. The clock's run up, time's up, over, blow. Now, Eminem pulls somewhat of a fast one on you here. He just said the word blow, which I don't think is a word, but it doesn't really seem that wrong because it's preceded with all the vowel sounds that sound exactly like it. Then for the rest of the verse, he just picks two vowel sounds and alternates between them. So he takes the line, snap back to reality, and he takes those sounds, and those become kind of the structure for the rest of the verse. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity, oh, there goes rabbit, he choked, he's so mad but he. Now when you use a combination of words, mad but he, to rhyme with a single word like gravity, that's called a mosaic rhyme. Won't give up that easy, no, he won't have it. He knows his whole back's to these ropes, it don't matter, he's dope, he knows that but he's broke, he's so standing, he knows, and so on and so forth. So if you go back to the first page of rhyme columns that we did, you'll notice there's almost no words in this entire song that don't rhyme with anything else. Now that's a far cry from the early days of Run-DMC when you were only rhyming the ends of the lines. He rhymes almost every single word in the song.